Hope you have watched the overview lectures of this course, Theory of Computation. Otherwise, please do it before you see this lecture. And today, we are going to start discussing the first topic in this course, which is about deterministic finite state automata. And in this lecture, we are going to see some example DFAs. So DFA means a finite state automata. And if you recall from the overview lecture, a finite state automata can be represented by a graph like this. So given this representation, it shows that in the given finite state automata, there are two states represented by the two nodes in this graph. And this state with a little arrow represents the start state of the automata, and this state represents a final state in the automata, and others are transitions. And here the question is, what language is accepted by this DFA? If you recall from the overview lecture, an input string is accepted if the processing or reading of the input string finishes in a final state. Otherwise, the automata rejects the input string. Okay. And a language is the set of all strings accepted by the finite state automata. Okay, and to answer this question, we can try to understand how the automata works on the given two input strings. Okay, I hope you remember how an automata works, but it doesn't matter if you don't remember, we can do it here. So, any automaton starts its processing from the start state. So, here this is the start state as indicated by this arrow. So, initially the machine is in the start state. And it needs to read the first symbol. What is the first symbol? It is A. So it reads off the first symbol and it moves along the edge for A. So it comes to this point. And that is what an automata will do on any input. It just reads the next input and accordingly it makes a transition depending on the input. And it do the next thing is, it needs to read the next symbol, and that is a B. And where is the B? V is taking you along the transition for B and you are coming back. In this case, it is a self loop. And anyway, that is what you have to do. And the next input symbol is A. So you take the transition for A, you are coming to this state. And the next input symbol is B, where you finish reading. So you do the transition for B and you finished in this state. If you recall, the definition is that if the reading terminated in a non-final state, then the input is rejected. So this input is rejected because you finished reading in a non-final state. Final state means this double circle. Okay. So that is what you did for the first input. And maybe we can try executing the machine for the second input to see what the language is. Okay, so we have now an input which is rejected, and see what is happening for the second input. So you start with the start state. The first symbol is B. So you take the transition for B. You are coming back to the same state. Next input symbol is A. So make the transition for A. You are coming to the other state. And now the last symbol you are going to process, which is a B. So you travel along the transition for B and you are finishing in a state which is a final state. So that means by definition, the second input is accepted. Why is it accepted? Is because you finished reading in a final state. Okay. So from these two inputs, the first one is rejected. And the second one is accepted because the first one, reading of first one finished in a non-final state, it is rejected. And the reading of the second string finished in the final state, so you accepted it. So you can say that the second string is in the language. But the question here is, what is the language? Or we have to identify the set of all strings accepted by the automaton. Here, from these transitions, it is clear that the automaton will accept a language over the alphabet set AB, because only A and B are the symbols which you can read using this automaton. Now the question is, can we generalize and say what kind of a string will be accepted? Can you make a guess? Okay, the answer is, the language of this automaton is the set of all strings X over the alphabets A and B such that the number of A's in X is odd. So the claim is that a given string X is accepted if there are odd number of A's, otherwise it will be rejected. See, in the first input there are two A's, it's not an even odd number, it is even, 2 is even, so it is rejected, that's fine. And the second contains 1 A, 1 is odd and it is accepted. So at least for these two input, the claim is correct. Now the question is the claim correct for an arbitrary input? To understand or to answer that question, we need to understand how this DFA works. How it works? Each state in the DFA represents a property of the input string read so far. So here, what is the question? You need to accept if the number of A's is odd. So how can you do it? Maybe if you have the ability, or the machine is having the ability to count the number of A's and B's, then what it do is just count you when you read the input symbols, and finally you check how many A's you read. If it is an odd number, accept, otherwise you reject. But unfortunately, counting is not possible with a finite state machine or DFA. Why is it not possible? We can see later. Okay, anyways, counting is not possible. But here we don't have to count. From the past input, we need to remember whether the number of A's seen so far is even or odd. Isn't it? That is the only thing that we need to remember while you read input, whether the number of A's is even or odd. Okay, so only two states are required. One means if you are in this state, that means the number of A's seen so far is even. And in this state means the number of A's seen so far is odd. So to start with, you have not seen any input symbol. So the number of A's is 0 and hence it is even. So it's meaningful to start with the even state. Okay. Now suppose you are in this state, that is so far number of A's is even. Then if you get a B, you don't have to move out because the B is not going to change the number of A's. So even means previously even means now also even. And suppose you get an A, what will happen? So far even number of A's, and you are going to read one more A means an even number plus 1, so odd number of A's. Okay, and from here also, if you are reading a B, you don't have to change the state because now odd number of A's, 1 B means the number of A's is not changed, so you stay back. And while you are in this state, that means so far odd number of A's, if you are getting one more A, an odd number plus 1, so the number of A's will be an even number, so you are moving back to the state E. Okay, so that is how this machine is defined. Hope now it's clear to you. So what property of the past input is remembered is this. The state E, the context is that the number of A's seen is even, and state O means the number of A's seen is odd. Okay. And this property is general for any finite state automaton. The states can be used to remember certain information about the string read so far. Okay, finitely many information can be remembered as the context of the states in the automaton. This is one example, and when we see more examples, things will be more clear to you. Hope it is clear, and let us move on to the second example. So here is another example. The question is same. What language is accepted? Okay, we want to identify the set of all strings accepted by this automaton. So maybe we can try what is happening for these inputs and try to generalize what the language is. Let us process the first input. The first symbol is A, and you are starting with the initial state. So you read the first symbol and make the corresponding transition. Okay, second symbol is B. So you move along the transition for B, and the third is A. So you move along the transition for A. And what is next? Next is the last symbol, which is a V, and which is taking you to the third state, and which is not a final state because only double circle represents a final state. So by definition, you are rejecting the first input. The first input is rejected. Okay, and maybe we can try it for the second input as well. Okay, so you have to start your processing with the first state. What is the first input symbol? It's B. So you move along to transition for B. And what is next? Next is an A. And that is taking you along the A transition to this state. And next is B. B is taking you to the third state. And the last one is again a B. And this time, the last B is taking you along the transition for B to a final state. So in this case, you finished reading in a final state, and so by definition of acceptance, you accept that string. And why is that accepted? Is because you finished reading in a final state. Now the question is that enough to generalize and say what kind of a string will be accepted? So the set of all strings of what kind will be accepted by this finite state automaton. Can you guess it? Okay, the claim here is that it accepts a string over AB. X is accepted if ABB is a substring in X. And that is true for the first two inputs. The first input is not containing ABB as a substring, so it is rejected. And the second string contains ABB as a substring, and that's why it is accepted. Okay, so from these two executions, we know that the claim is correct for these two input. But is it correct in general? To understand that, we can see how this automaton is processing the input. So basically, you want to accept an input if ABB is contained in the input string. So your objective is to look in the input to see ABB. Okay, how can you read ABB? For that, initially you have not processed any symbols from ABB. So zero symbols from ABB, that is represented by epsilon. Epsilon means it's an empty string or a string of no symbols. This is a representation or notation which represents a string of zero symbols. Okay, so in order to read ABB, you have to first read A, then AB, then ABB. Okay, and before reading the first symbol, what is read? Nothing is read, which is represented by epsilon. Okay, so then to read ABB, first you have to read the first symbol of ABB, which is A. After that, you have to read a B. By that, you are reading the first two symbols of ABB. Okay, then you have to read the last symbol. If you do that, then you can say that you read the whole substring. Okay, if you do that, you can accept. Otherwise, you cannot accept. Okay, and these strings are called the prefixes of ABB. Prefix means zero or more simples from the left side. Okay, from the left side, zero simple means epsilon, one simple means A, two simples means AB, three simples means ABB. Okay, and with this information, we can try to understand what this DFA is doing. And if you look at the DFA, now you can see that the states of the DFA are named with the prefixes of the substring that you are searching for. Okay, and that is true for all substring automata. Okay, the states are going to be the prefixes of the given substring. If a substring is of length k, there will be k plus 1 prefixes like this. So there will be k plus 1 states. Okay, now maybe with this example, we can try to understand what the DFA is doing and what are these prefixes or states, etc. So what is the first simple? The first simple, before you read anything, and what is seen from the prefix set? Nothing is seen from the prefix. So you have to be in the state with the name epsilon. That is, initially you are in the state with epsilon. Maybe you can say that you are initially in the state with epsilon. You are here. Maybe let me take a copy of it to point where we are. Okay. So initially we are here. Okay. And is it meaningful? To start with, we have not read any simple at all. So the part of ABV that we have read is epsilon, nothing. Okay, you are here. And initially you are going to read the first simple. What is it? It's a B. Is B allows you to read a part of this? No, it is not allowing. So after even reading B, what part of ABV is read is only epsilon. And that is why you stay back. Okay. And now what is the next simple? Next simple is important, which is part of the input string that you are going to read. Okay. So it's A. Okay. So A means you have to take this transition. Okay. You just have read two simples, but out of the two simples, the last simple is important. Why is it important? Because it is the first simple of the substring. Okay, so I have to remember it in my state, and that is why I moved on to A. A means now I have read the first simple of the substring, and that's the meaning. Okay, and what is next? Maybe we can try to extend. Next is AA. If I next simple is A, so do I have to remember both these A's? No, because AA is not in the prefix set. Okay, so I don't have to remember. So from the last, the only thing I can remember is the last A, because which is a prefix. Okay, I do remember only a prefix, and that is what I do. So this A doesn't matter. So I remember this A only. Why? Because I remember only these prefixes from the rightmost part of the input I read so far. Okay, and that is why I stay back. Okay, because AA is not a prefix. Okay, now see what is the next input simple. It is B. Okay, so B means is it is AB a prefix here? Yes, it is a prefix. So you have to make a move to AB, and that is why you come to a state whose name is AB. Okay, that means from the input, so far I read the first two simples of the substring that I am looking for. Okay, and now try to extend. The next input simple is A. So is AB a prefix? No, it is not a prefix. So I cannot remember ABA as such. So what is the best thing you can remember from the last? So you can either remember ABA or AB. Can you remember AB? Sorry, or BA. from the last only, okay, you are trying to remember the last few simples. ABA is not possible because it's not a substring or prefix. And so try whether I can remember BA or not. Anyway, this A is not going to help you. Is BA here? No, it's not here. So what is there? So the only thing is you can remember only this A. Okay, so to when I read the next simple, the only thing that I read from this substring is this A only. So I have to move back to a state whose context is A. Okay, so that's what I am doing. And the next simple is B. If I read it, AB is a prefix, so I move along the line to AB, and the next input is B, and ABB as such is a prefix, and that is what I am looking for. So I am moving to ABB, and in this case I stopped reading and I did it in this state, and so I accept. Okay, so that's it. And if you recall what we did, while we read the input, we are trying to remember the last few simples, the maximum such simples, which is forming a prefix, okay, which is forming a prefix in this set. So if we recollect, what we are doing is, while reading the input, the DFA maintains in its state the largest suffix. Suffix means the last few simples. Prefix means from the left, zero or more simples. Suffix means from the right, zero or more simples. Okay, so it remembers the largest prefix. If you recall, here the largest prefix is ABB. Okay, and that's it. It maintains in its state, what is remembered in its state is the largest suffix. When you come here, the largest suffix from the red part, which is a prefix, is epsilon. Then in this case it is A, this case it is AB, and in this case it is ABB. So what it maintains in state is the largest suffix of the processed part of the input, which matches with the prefix of the substring. You look at the largest prefix, which is a, sorry, the largest suffix, which is a prefix of the string that you are searching for. Okay, and that is the logic. And if you recollect, then the context of the state is epsilon means, as of now, I have not seen ABB, and what I read from A, ABB is only epsilon. Okay, state A means, so far I have not seen ABB, and what part of ABB I have seen at the end of the string that I read so far is A. Similarly, AB says it is AB, and ABB says I have seen ABB, okay, for this particular automaton, and that's it. So you, once you reach into this state, no need to worry about what I do from there onwards, because I have seen ABB. Regardless of the remaining set of symbols, I can happily stay back in the accept state, and finally it will allow me to accept. So that is this machine. And remember that when you design a finite state automaton for searching for a substring, then the states are going to be the prefixes of the substring that you are searching for. Okay, hope you followed it. Otherwise, please watch it again. And with this, I am moving to the last slide of this lecture, where I am giving you a number of assignment questions. So you have to design DFAs for the following languages. The first one is that you accept all the strings X over AB such that the number of A's in X is odd and the number of B's in X is even. Okay, odd number of A's and even number of B's. Try to design a machine for that. And L2, another language for which you have to come up with a DFA. And what is the language? Over AB again, but said that the string starts with A. You want to accept if the string starts with the simple A. Okay, then the third language is that, say, substring searching automaton. and you accept a string X if BAB is not a substring in X. Okay. In the example that we discussed, we were searching for a substring, and when we got the substring, we stayed in that state and accepted, right? But here it is a reverse question. You search for a substring, and if that substring is present, you reject. If the substring is not present, you have to accept. And that's it. And with this, I am finishing this lecture, and please try to understand what we discussed today, and also try to solve the assignment problems. And see you in the next class. Thank you.